Tonight on Tim and Eric Night Live, Forrest Whitaker and John Mayer.
What's hot in the net?
Entertainment news, new news.
Fashion report.
Eric, you dummy.
Spurs.
Say what?
Hey. Hi, everybody. Welcome to a very exciting special edition of Tim and Eric Night Live, Valentine's Day edition.
Love is in the air, Tim. It's a sexual night. It's going to be so exciting.
Absolutely. We have so much wonderful things planned. Obviously, we're in the spirit, getting ready, dressed up here in pink with all the balloons, wonderful balloons. We want to thank everybody for setting this up.
Thanks, guys. We're going to have a big Valentine's Day card. Valentine's. You know what you do? You give your lover or your loved one a card, and tonight, our viewers have been sending us tons of cards, and we're going to be counting them over the night and see who wins, Tim or me.
I can guess right now it's going to be me by a landslide, because I know all you guys out there appreciate the work I do in the show. Thanks for all the Valentines.
And I think I'll win.
Well, why don't we take a look at some of the Valentines that have been coming in. They've been coming in all week, and what an exciting... Oh, here we go, just a few. Wow. Eric? All right. Guys, do we know, is anybody edging out anybody else? No? Oh, this is a good one. Look at it. Dear Tim, what does your sex look like? My sex is just for you. Secret admirer.
Well, that's really sweet.
Pretty good.
This one for me. Dear Eric, I'm a tiny tattooed woman who prefers a large gen. Would you make me a mommy? Love, Kellen James. Thank you so much, Kellen.
Here's one. Dear Tim, last night I dreamed you mounted me from behind. I woke up and changed the sheets. Love, Chrissy. So that's a nice one. That's a thoughtful one.
Let's do one more. Dear Eric, are you into threesomes?
Yes.
My uncle and I want to experiment, from Mike Parcell. Wow.
Well, Eric, talk about, we're going to have the winner of the contest. One of us is going to get to spend some time in the loser's area, which we're calling the Dunder the Covers.
The loser of this, whoever has the least amount of cards, spends some time in Dunder the Covers. Mm-hmm. The winner gets to do a romantic sexual journey in the Tunnel of Love.
Oh, the Tunnel of Love.
So
that sounds nice.
With a beautiful Gabby who's in the studio today. Mm-hmm. And I'm hoping to win that because I think Gabby is... very attractive, and I love the Tunnel of Love.
You know, speaking of Dunder the Covers, why don't we take an opportunity right now and check in with Richard Dunn, Dunder the Covers.
Bless with beautiful women. Do a little punning and a little pushing, a little poking. Dunder the Covers.
All right, Richard.
Yes. We Sorry
have
to interrupt.
Dunn here, like... and we have the beautiful Gabby. What are you guys doing over there?
Introduced to each other.
Can we pan over to see Gabby, or is that... You guys got to block these shots out.
Gabby, if you could just look straight up and say hello. That's the beautiful Gabby. Yeah. There's Richard Dunn. And the loser of the Valentine's contest will take Gabby's place and spend some time with Richard, which is not that fun.
And Gabby's going to join one of us, probably me, in the Tunnel of Love. And that's going to be something to look forward to.
Well, Richard, we'll be checking back in with you as the show goes on. Have fun on the bed.
Keep it
you
clean.
Know what I mean.
You can go as far as you like. We got permission from everybody here. We're all fine with wherever you want to take that situation, and you know, just use protection.
You know, have fun with it. This week is about love. It's about sensual activities. So really, just explore yourselves.
If you guys want to get started, just send us a flag of some kind. Just let us know. What's going on? Try to keep it down because you guys are mic'd for sound over there. We don't want to interrupt some of the other segments, but if you do want to start making love, just go about it in an honest and open way. All right.
All right, let's check in with Ben now for the Valentine's Day card count. Ben, how are we doing? Who's up?
Oh, my goodness.
Looks like I'm doing okay.
Oh,
all right, looks like I'm way up.
Well,
thank you, Ben.
It's a little bit too early to call.
Well, I figured as much.
But, you know, I want to just come out and say that I think the whole Valentine's holiday is kind of a scam, and it's just not. It's always about sex, and you know, sex is fine, but it's not the end all be all. Life's about a lot more than just that. So.
Right, but the problem is that you've never had sex. So how would you know?
I've had plenty of sex. There's no question about that. And
why don't you show everyone and me what you think sex is, and
just show you right.
Yeah. Let's see how you.
If you want to put this to bed,
how Tim Heidecker has sex.
I will show you how I have sex. I think it's just like every other red-blooded American. I do what everybody else does. I take my pants down, and I just grab onto my balls, and squeeze them as hard as I can, and I just squeeze. If I just keep holding that pressure, I keep holding that down, and I'm gonna come. Okay, I'm gonna come. Here I go. And I gotta squeeze up. Ah!
Right.
And that's.
That's fine.
What it is.
That's great, but that's actually not having sex like you would have sex with a woman.
Paper towel.
That's what I'm talking about. You can't understand the power of Valentine's Day when that is what you think is sex.
Okay. Can we go on a break? Because I got to clean this up. I'm not going to sit down in this. Are we going to cook?
Ben, could...
I'll sit in it, but...
Ben.
You want me to sit in it? You want me to sit in this? Do you have another chair?
Just cut to B-roll or something. Get another chair.
It's cum on the chair, so. We are all back. Right. We figured that one out.
Right now, we're going to introduce our guest. He's the romantic heartthrob musician, John Mayer.
Welcome, John. Thanks so much. Thanks for coming. I'm sure I appreciate it. This is normal. Yeah, don't wash my hands. Wash my hands. I got all over the way we're going to do it is you're going to actually sit right here, and we have a microphone for you. We weren't able to get the lav situation figured out, but don't worry about that. Take a
Thank
sit
you.
And we'll just be comfortable.
I will, but people can't.
Just, you don't need to put it so close to your mouth. It can just be natural with it. If we had a lav like this, you wouldn't need that. But why don't we sit back over there? Well, welcome John Mayer to our set. Thank you very much. Very popular musician, rock musician.
John is here in the spirit of Valentine's Day, and he's going to offer up some of his romantic advice, some sex tips to Tim and I, and
John,
try to help us through.
Sure. You're known as a talented guitar player and singer, but you're also known as quite a bit of a heartthrob. You're a handsome man. You have had a lot of luck with the ladies. But don't you think that, you know, the whole sex thing's overrated? Don't you believe that this holiday is a bit of a farce, or is it something that you embrace?
I think if you're with somebody that you really enjoy being with, then obviously the context of that experience grows immeasurably.
Absolutely. I agree with you, John. John, here's something that I've thought about while listening to your music. Have you ever put on one of your CDs while you're making love to another woman and listened to that together?
I haven't. That would be... I think that would make the person that I was with.
Right.
Well, I don't want to say woman. I just want to say person right now.
Let me ask you, take it one step further. Have you ever sung one of your songs during intercourse?
Not during, but unbeknownst to me, I have sung one of my songs, what ended up being before intercourse. You can't see these things coming all the time. But
I knew it.
There have been times where I could look back and say, you know what, that was the moment where it all went well.
That makes sense.
Yeah. I think that you come on here and you act like you are God's gift to women. And honestly, it is a little obnoxious, and it certainly makes us look like idiots.
I don't really know how to respond to that. I'm a really, really big fan of your show, and there are certain times where I just want to sit in the chair as a fan of your show with a BlackBerry full of beautiful women's numbers. That BlackBerry is off, so it's about you guys right now.
Right.
John, you know, I think we should tell him the surprise.
All right, well,
I don't want to get into weird stuff because you've got your own life and I got my own life and you don't.
John and I have talked about it last week. We both know that you have never had sex with a real woman, and we have a little surprise for you. We are gonna pop that cherry tonight.
Okay.
John and I put our money together. We hired a very beautiful prostitute for you tonight on Nite Live. You're going to be able to make love to her as many times as you want, however you'd like, and this will give you a real experience
This is for real.
John's idea.
Eric and I swapped John's photos idea. On the internet a lot. Uh-huh. We went through a lot of different people, and we settled on this wonderful woman.
Her name is Shelly. Let's bring her out. Let's meet her.
Who is this?
Tim, you this is really your prostitute, Shelly.
You guys set this up? Oh my God. Hi, how are you?
Thank you so much. You're doing a great job.
Jeez, you guys didn't, I could have just sit.
Does Shelly need to take this?
Probably.
Shelly, how are you tonight?
I'm good.
Thank you so much for coming on.
Well, for the record, I could have sex with a woman without needing you guys to do this, but I appreciate it.
Well, Tim, this is what we want you to do. We want you to take Shelly to the green room and get to know each other, because sex is not just about the physical intercourse. It's about the emotional relationships that you can develop. So why don't you guys go back for about 10 minutes and just get to know each other before you make sex.
All right. Be happy to.
Thank you so much, Shelly. And to even top that, Tim, I took a little time earlier this week with the help of my friend John, and I wrote a song that explains to Tim how you make sex with a woman. And it's not about squeezing her balls. It's about a whole other level of intimate and romantic activities. And here it is. Check it out. My video to Tim.
You don't have to squeeze your balls, my friend, to make love to a woman. Shout just to make that goo come out, 'cause it's more than that. You put it in her hole, it's warm in there, then you lose control.
But please be careful about blue balls, because if you don't come, you might become frustrated and your testicles will turn blue and fall off, and that hurts.
Sex is about the in and out, push your guy in and make her grin. Off your balls and listen to the calls of a sexy woman that needs deep dickin'. Come inside so the baby comes alive, give her a son, and then you'll all have fun.
All right, that was a special music video that I made for Tim Heidecker, my friend. Let's check in with Dunder to the Covers and see how you two are doing. What's going on, Gabby?
What's going on?
Yeah, are you excited to take Tim or I on a wonderful Tunnel of Love ride later?
Yeah, it might be kind of naughty.
I hope I win the Valentine's contest, because I think we'll have a fun time, right, Rich?
Don't ask him about that.
Yeah. Hey, Tim, let's check in with Tim Heidecker and Shelly in the back room. Are you guys getting acquainted?
I feel like I can experience different kinds of emotions. You know, like if I was free to say the way I feel, I could say it, but I feel like because of my relationships I've had, they've kind of helped me for...
Looks like they're getting to know one another. Ben, do we have the final Valentine's Day card count? Are we settled? All right, at this time we're going to bring in our Nite Live Cupid, Michael Schmidt, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Michael. Good to see you again. Right now, all the Valentine's cards are in, and we're going to actually weigh them. Whoever has the heaviest bag is the winner. They go on the Tunnel of Love ride. Whoever is the loser, the lightest bag, has got to go Dunder to the Covers. Ladies and gentlemen, Cupid, please weigh our cards.
Thank you.
Kim wins.
Wow, ladies and gentlemen. I guess great news for Tim Heidecker. Wow. That looks like I'm going done to the covers. Looks like Tim Heidecker won the Tunnel of Love ride. Tim, are you excited to take a ride with Gabby or what?
Eric, if it's okay with you and Ben and everybody, I would like to go on the Tunnel of Love ride with Shelly here.
Okay. I think we can arrange okay? that. Tim's going to take a Tunnel of Love ride with Shelly, and that means I'm heading over to Dunder the Cover. Shelly, if you wouldn't mind, I'm going to have to take your place. Thank you so much, John Mayer, for being on the show.
Tim and Eric. So dangerous, you know, for me. Let's go to the Tunnel of Love. Come on.
Ride down, baby, into this tunnel of love.
A bonding moment.
Two friends, yeah.
Just want you to know that. My honesty will.
Could be nice, Gabby.
Precedence over everything else. What do you think?
Most interesting. They're showing credits now.
Just think, you know, the world of you. Think the world of you. I want that to be permanent. The heart's permanent. Mind, forget it.